Creating and customizing games is one of my biggest passions. To make my own worlds with their own stories and mechanics, and then to watch people live in it, enjoy their time, struggle through their challenges, and celebrate once they get over them is always an enjoyable feeling. The only problem is that creating those worlds can be fairly challenging, which is why when I learned about this plugin called Denizen, I got excited as a child, and experienced what can only be described as an accurate representation of monkey-sees action neuroactivation. Denizen is an incredible plugin that allows you to do basically what every other plugin can do, and a bit more, allowing you to create your very own plugins as long as you are willing to put the effort in. In all the years I've been working on creating stuff in Minecraft, creating things with Denizen has probably been the one I most enjoyed, because it's both simple and powerful. So let me show you what is possible to do with Denizen. This is a file with the .dsc extension, or Denizen script. What we are doing here is a simple chat plugin, and although I believe it might not be the best way to do it, it is one of the simplest, and for the sake of this video, it is the best option. The plan here is to have two ways to send messages in chat. If you just say something, it will be sent to anyone within a 50 block radius. If your message starts with @g, it means it is global, and it will be sent to everyone online. The first few lines tell the script its name, what is its type, we'll see a few different ones soon, and, since it's a world script, when it should activate. In this case, we'll use the on-player chat event, where if you go on Denizen's documentation, there is a huge list of events, such as player joins, player left clicks block, and entity damaged. Line 5 tells the server that the original message shouldn't be sent, therefore cancelled, else it would send both our formatted message and the original one. This passively tag only means that the code should keep executing, else cancelled would just stop everything there. Line 6 and 7 make the code cleaner by telling it that 1. When I say message, I'm referring to the message in this context, and 2. Speaker is about the player that sent the message. Then, it asks a question. Does this message start with @g? If the answer is yes, we tell Denizen that the message should only start after the first @g, and then we print for everyone online the speaker's name and the message formatted however we want. If not, then we have some extra steps to do. First, we send the message formatted to the original sender of the message. Then, we execute a for each loop, which takes a list of entities or objects to do something with and executes it for every single one of them, and in this case, we are calling them listeners. So, for each listener, I get the distance from the location where the speaker is to where they are, and then I round the number down. Lastly, I send to this listener the formatted message, which includes the distance. There's other ways to do that for each loop, and I could instead do the following code. And although this might have a bit more of a better performance, it is too messy, and if I ever decide to go back and change it or someone else decides to read my code, it is slightly more confusing and might take more time to fix or adjust anything. The performance there is probably negligible, so we'll just revert back to the last one. For testing purposes, I'll make the range 10 blocks and make the server tell everyone whenever someone sends a message. Now, as you can see, if I ask my friends here to send a message in chat starting with @g, I can see it. But if I ask them to send anything without @g, I can't see it. If I get closer, I can see both the message and how distant the player is from me. Okay, we've done our first script, which was of the type world, which executes some code based on an event. We also have a lot of other possible script types we can use, such as command scripts that allow you to create custom commands, enchantment ones that allow you to make custom enchantments, such as in my enchantments video, entity scripts, which allow you to spawn entities with custom data, and item scripts, which is what we'll be using next. What we'll be doing is making an X capable of executing an exploding attack that will deal damage in an area when you right-click. Let's start with the item script before going to these skills. Let's break this down really quickly because I know it looks like a lot, but it's just kind of overwhelming. First, name and type once again. Then, we tell which item will be used as a base. Then we give it some mechanisms, which is equivalent to most NBT data, so if it's unbreakable, if there's custom model data, and in this case the attributes. Then we give it the movement speed attribute, so we'll make the player slower when they're holding the axe in their hand. Now we give it an actual name and a description. Then an enchantment and some crafting recipes. All of this can be found in the Denizen documentation as well, you just need to head to the item script container section, and they have a very good explanation of what each thing is. Okay, item done, let's properly make the skill, but this time we'll use two different scripts. This is a simple script, that tells the server to run another script when someone clicks with the Berserker's Axe item. And I'll soon show to you why would we do that instead of just putting the skill in here. So now, we make the second script, which will contain the actual skill. This one will be a task script, which literally just means that it will be called once and do whatever it's supposed to do, instead of waiting for an event or containing some NCR item. We can do it in a very straightforward way that simply spawns an explosion at the player's location, but this will have a very clear problem. The explosion is not limited to entities around the player and will probably deal more damage to him than to other entities. We could probably fix that by very briefly applying the resistance effect to the player, but this would push the player and still deal damage to his armor and throw them around, so this is also no good. Maybe we can find a different way to deal with that then. We'll start by removing the explosion command, and we'll do it manually. First, we define a range of effect, the damage it should deal, the strength of the push horizontally, and the strength vertically, and we'll get a list of entities that will be affected using the range value. Notice that we are excluding the player from the list because we don't want them to be hurt or pushed as well. Then, we do a for each loop like we did before, but instead of calling the elements listeners, we call them entities. This doesn't really matter, it's just a name choice that we can use to reference them. So, we define the direction that they'll be pushed towards by subtracting the entity's coordinate from the player's coordinate and normalizing it, which means that the sum of all values will be a total of 1 while still keeping the same proportion. So now you can imagine an arrow pointing from the player to the entity with a distance of 1, and that would be the value of the direction variable. Now, we adjust the entity's velocity to be this variable multiplied by strengths previously decided, and just cause some damage with the cause of an entity explosion. After that, we play a few effects and sounds, add a cooldown, and boom, we have the skill done. Now, you might be asking, why did we make a separate world script? Well, imagine you do 100 of those skills, and save all of them in a single world script. That wouldn't be really viable, or at least pretty and easy to read. So if you had a code like this one, you could know what each part of it does what. This is not the best example, but it should give you a general idea of how much more organized it can make your code. This is just a percentage of what Denizen is capable of doing, as the heights that you can reach with Denizen should be as high as what any other Java coded plugin ceiling would be. Personally, it is the best plugin I've ever seen, as it makes the life of those who want extremely specific plugins that much easier. Anyways, that is about all I had to say in the Denizen topic. I know this video will be a bit of a longer one, and that it's a bit different than my usual content, which focuses way more on showcasing instead of explaining. But let me know what you think of it, and if you'd like more of those, be it going deeper into Denizen or with other plugins such as Mythic Mobs and Model Engine. Either way, thank you all for watching, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss my next videos. And as always, I'll see you guys on the next one.